So we take these two resistors as one series and these two as other series. And to get the final resistance, we just sum each one of the resistors and we get this one. First one is 15 ohms, second one is 25 ohms.
I'm going to sum each one of them, but like in the quotient. So this and this, plus this, plus this, and we have this, and we have it to the minus one, so we need to like to put it in the other way, and we get a result of 4.84 ohms. And now we have it like, this is our simplified diagram of the current. And in order to get the final current, we need to use this formula. So we need to use the voltage divided by the resistance and 10 volts divided by 4.84 ohms, and that gives us a result of 2.11 amperes. That is the total power.
Once we have the total current and the total voltage and the total resistance, we need to know in this diagram, the previous one, the same data. We know that the resistance is 10, 25 and 15, and as it is a parallel diagram, we know that the voltage is equal in each one of the currents. So voltage is going to be equal to 10 volts in each of these currents. Then we have left to find the current, and remember that current is equal to voltage over resistance. So we perform the operations in each, and 10 volts over 25 gives us 0.4 amperes, 10 over 10 gives us 1 ampere, and 10 over 15 gives us 0.66 amperes.
Finally, to get the final voltage from each one, we take the result from the last diagram, and we know that the current is the same from the last one, but we have to calculate the voltage with this formula to obtain these ones because they are in parallel. And so we get the voltage 6.6 volts, 3.3, 2 volts, and 3 volts.